In the previous video, we saw how we can handle systems of linear equations with one variable or one equation. We're now going to tackle the more general problem when the system can have more than one variable and one equation. The idea is to reduce the system down to one variable or one equation. How exactly do we do that? We'll look at an example. So I have a system with three unknowns, x1, x2, x3, and three equations. And let's say we are working over the rational numbers. What I'm going to do is, I'm going to rewrite the first equation as follows. So I'm going to add x2 to both sides, and then multiply the result by 1/2 on both sides. And that will give us x1 equals 1/2 x2. What this is saying is, if I know what value of x2 is, then x1 has to be 1/2 x2. Now, armed with that knowledge, what I can do is, every time I see x1, I can replace it with 1/2 x2. So in equation 2, what we'll get is minus 1/2 x2 plus x2 minus 2x3 equal to 4. And then in the third equation, I'm going to have 3/2 x2 minus 2x2 plus x3 equal to minus 2. And if I simplify both equations, I'll get 1/2 x2 here, and this one will be minus 1/2 x2. What this is saying is, if I want to solve this system up here, all I need to do is find values for x1, x2, x3 satisfying this system. But now, if I look at these two equations, they form a system with two unknowns and two equations. It has one fewer variable and one fewer equation than the original system. And again, we can apply the same idea. So I'm going to write 1/2 x2 as 4 plus 2x3. So what that means is, anytime I see 1/2 x2, I can replace it with this. So I'm now concentrating on this system. So I have a minus 1/2 x2, so I can replace it with minus 4 plus 2x3, right? Because 1/2 x2 is 4 plus 2x3, so minus 1/2 x2 is this. And then plus x3 equal to minus 2. But now, if I focus on this equation, what I'll get is minus x3 is equal to 2. So x3 has to be minus 2. There's no other value that x3 can take. But now, once I know what x3 is, I can get back x2, because up here, 1/2 x2 is written as 4 plus 2x3. So from here, I'm going to get x2 equal to 0. Okay? Now that I know x2 has to be 0, what does that tell me about x1? Well, x1 has to be 0 as well. So there you go. I have solved the system. So the only solution is going to be x1, x2, x3 equal to 0, 0, and minus 2. So say if I give you a system with, say, 5 variables and 10 equations, you can do the same thing to reduce that system. First, you pick one of the equations, and then pick one of the variables in the equation, say x1, and write x1 in terms of the other variables. And then, every time you see x1 in other equations, you substitute that with the expression that you have for x1. That way, you have a system that has one fewer variable and one fewer equation. And you can do this repeatedly until you get down to one variable or one equation. Having said that, I'd like to point out that the method described in this video assumes that we're working over a field. If a system is not specified over a field, it can become quite hard to solve. Such a system can give rise to a whole new topic, which we won't do here.